Am I asking for the moon? Is it really so implausible that you and I could soon come to some kind of arrangement? I'm not asking for the moon. I've always been a realist when it's really nothing more than a simple rearrangement. With one roof above our heads, a warm house to return to, we could start with separate beds. I could sleep alone or learn to. I'm not suggesting that we find some earthly paradise forever. I mean, how often does that happen now? The answer's probably never. But we could come to an arrangement, a practical arrangement, and you could learn to love me, given time.
Well, I like my independence. I get by, I'm not greedy. Do you see yourself as Galahad? Do I really look that needy? I brought a child up on my own. Takes me all my strength to face him. The father upped and left me, and I'm not desperate to replace him. Tell me, what kind of catch is a struggling single mother? I respect you and I like you, but I won't accept another empty promise when some gray and stormy rain cloud hangs above me. When I've heard it all 100 times from a man who said he loved me. But if we came to an arrangement, a practical arrangement, then perhaps I'd learn to love you, given time.
I'm not promising the moon. I'm not promising a rainbow. Just a practical solution to a solitary life. I'd be a father to your boy, a shoulder you could lean on. How bad could it be to be my wife? With one roof above our heads, a warm house to return to, you wouldn't have to cook for me, you wouldn't have to learn to. I'm not suggesting that this proposition here could last forever. I've no intention of deceiving you. You're far too clever. But we could come to an arrangement, a practical arrangement, and perhaps you'd learn to love me, given time. It may not be the warmest that you had in mind, but you could learn to love me, given time.